It is quite a unique flight sim for me because I grew up playing it. And yeah, it is not special because of great flight mechanics, great graphics, which you can find in modern sims as well. No, what made it really special was its campaign and pilot management system. Yeah, and I recently got it on Steam. I think I even got it below one buck on a sale, so you see the game is really not expensive to get. Yeah. The reviews are negative because there's some technical issues and some people, you know, it's understandable. They get a game and want to start immediately into it. If they encounter issues, they, I don't know, give up or don't want to. It's fine, but I will give you a small guide, or others already also made this, and then you can also run it on Windows 10 even and some modifications even on higher graphics. However, I remember I played back then, but I remember I had some issues, not sure, if it was game related, computer related or whatever. I remember there was some issues with the game when it released, that there was some bugs, but you know, it is really a long time since this was. I was very young, and yeah, but still, I think this game holds a special place, and that's why I wanted to showcase it. So yeah, first things first, I got it on Steam, then you install it. Yeah, and you will notice if you start, when you start it, you will get in something like a windowed mode, which you might not want to do to play in. But there's a way to turn it into full screen. Let me first do a sound check. Okay. Yeah. I think I don't even need Steam for that. Yeah, but you can also launch it with Steam. You will get this config tool here. You can set some stuff. Yeah, it is showing you a max resolution of 1000. It is an old game. But yeah, this is, I will explain why. But we will get it to full HD. Yeah, there's always a solution. We will find it. Find solutions and don't make problems. That's the motto here. One problem is still persistent. It looks like there are some limitations of sound on modern systems. It is minimal. You won't hear ATC and Wingman talk, but other than that, I didn't feel a difference. But yeah, I don't know. Sometimes it's those old games, they don't recognize those modern sound systems, and then they lock you to the lowest settings. Perhaps somebody else will find a solution. Feel welcome to comment. Yeah, and those settings, sure, you can set something with the resolution here. I tried it out, didn't work out. At least not to set up higher resolutions. Yeah, next. Let's first check some Steam stuff I found. Yeah, that is the store page, and here is the community guide page. And here will you find some things that also helped me, for example, this kick FAQ. Yeah. This didn't work out for me, this regulator. I will show you a different solution. For me, it didn't work out. I couldn't set it to a high resolution. Yeah, okay, that's not that important. Yeah, I don't know. It is already set to compatibility when you install it. It is already set to this. So that's fine. Yeah, one interesting thing, I found it here. You can. Yeah, exactly. You start the game in windowed mode, and in your main folder in your Steam installation, you find this here. This here, Typhoon 2000 registration. If you run this, you can add something to your registry, and I think it will switch to full screen. Sure, it is a bit complicated that you need to do it from your game folder. Many people don't even know that there is a Steam game folder, but yeah, you will manage, yeah. And there's even a further thing you can do. You can modify it. Yeah, there's a lot of gibberish, but if you want return to windowed, I think you need to set the last number to 1. Yeah, I don't know, perhaps you can tinker around with other stuff. Sound would be great. Perhaps you can force higher sound quality. I looked over it, didn't find anything. Whatever, next. If you start the game, it is 1000, locked to a resolution to 1000. It is okay, but would be greater if you can go full HD, of course. And for this I use Voodoo, or DXDG, yeah, DG Voodoo, whatever. There's enough tutorials, I already explained enough in other videos. It is a great tool, which helps you to run older games with better settings and better DirectX and whatever. I use usually this setting here. I mean, you can copy them. Yeah, it will basically put this old game into a new DirectX, and then you can set a higher resolution, anti-aliasing, AF. You can also use NVIDIA. Yeah, we don't need the watermark, but I will leave it on for the video so you see it works. In the beginning, it is a big help to know if Voodoo hooked. And yeah, I currently don't have the Voodoo folder open. I wanted to keep it open for this video, but you will find, if you download Voodoo, you will get this control panel and three folders, MS, Glide, and I think 3DFX. MS stands for Microsoft, DirectX is Microsoft, so you need to get the contents of the folder. These are these files here, copy them. There's one thing, there's two folders in the MS folder, x86, x64. I usually copy first the x86 stuff, and then I copy this single file of the 64-bit folder and overwrite it. It works for me. I don't know exactly if this is required, but I do it like this. Don't touch a running system. Yeah, I don't think I have currently a folder here nearby. And yeah, exactly. This control tool need to be primed towards a folder. You can press this button simply here. It will then select the folder in which the control panel exe is located. Yeah, because you can do other games as well from a single control panel. You don't need to keep this file like I do here in the folder, but I'm lazy. I always keep them in the game folder, and then you press this and do the settings. Yeah. And yeah, 3DFX Glide is not important. DirectX, this game runs on DirectX. And then you're done. You can launch it. Yeah, it runs even. That is. Yeah, okay.
No one could have predicted that in the early years of a new millennium, world peace would hang on the fate of one remote island. In a time of global harmony, few believed that the formidable strength of NATO would be challenged and tested. In Europe, the specter of an old enemy has arisen, with intent to settle unfinished business between East and West. Now only Iceland stands between peace and World War III.
You see the watermark here in the lower right corner. It tells you that Voodoo is successfully working. And then you can remove the watermark, so you can play without this visual annoyance. Yeah, it's a bit loud. I will set the game. Perhaps I need to restart it sometimes, but I think this game is fine with tubbing. Okay. Yeah, we are in, and you have basically four options. You can start, well, yeah, multiplayer. I don't know about multiplayer. I never played this in multiplayer. Would be interesting to know if you can play the campaign in multiplayer. Perhaps I shouldn't have pressed it. Let's see what we can host. Yeah, I knew it. Okay, yeah. I don't know if there's a direct multiplayer, but come on, most of you want to play it, I guess, as of a single player. I mean, if the multiplayer would be with a campaign, like in Falcon, it would be a different story. But do some random dogfights with somebody, I don't know, I don't see really that big interest in it. But if you play a campaign, co-op or multiplayer, that would be a different story, like you can do in Falcon BMS. That is, of course, absolutely a different experience. Yeah, and about this game, why is it so special for me? Not because of the flag model. I think the flag model is even not that great. It is a Simcade game. It is not, you have nothing, you can't click anything in the cockpit. Unfortunately, it is no Falcon. I would have rather something like Falcon, where you have a cockpit with buttons, or like DCS. But this is more like, I don't know if it is comparable, Strike Fighters. That is also some flight sim series. It is not realistic, but it is somehow, I mean, those missiles don't fly 500 miles. It's not Ace Combat, but it's not a flight sim either. It is between. Yeah, I think Strike Fighters is a good example. Simcade, I would say. A game tied to some realism aspects, yeah, but what the heck. Okay, yeah, campaign. You have two options. You can start in peacetime or in wartime. I think peacetime gives you a bit more time before stuff is getting hot, which can be great, because there's some, yeah, this, sorry, but this watermark is annoying me. I will now get rid of it. Yeah, you press this and then the watermark is gone. And the wartime campaign, as the name suggests, you will start, not, this is not completely, the war is not gone, but it seems like political, diplomatic measures have ceased, and yeah, and then you face a surprise attack on Iceland. This game is not set in a Cold War, it is set in a modern era, and basically it is Russia versus the NATO. Not sure what happened, but you will see news reports, really well made. We will check it out. And like I said, the flight mechanics, everything, it is fine. You can work with it. It is not bad, but it is not what makes the game special. If this game would be released with those flight mechanics, without the campaign, nobody would care. I wouldn't have cared about this game. So let's start a new game in peacetime. And you already see something quite unique. You can select what pilots you can. Those pilots have different abilities, different personalities. You can see, for example, this guy here has 4,500 hours on a Typhoon. Typhoon is quite new aircraft, so some are still new. A Spanish guy, Swedish, right. Duke, villain, the villain is cool. Redhead, Baron, Let's get the villain here. Midnight, okay. Yeah, you select your pilots, you can read. Yeah, one thing I forgot is why it also has negative reviews is that there is no documentation coming with the install. Yeah, man, do a Google search, perhaps. I know it should be in the game, sure, but I don't know. The time you invested in a negative review, you could simply Google this. Or here somebody posted all manuals in all languages you can download quickly. It looks like this. You will get a keyboard layout. I have it in English. Then you will get a manual, and here I can show you some stuff what will happen. Those pilots, you will lift those pilots. Those pilots have personalities. Here's even some further information about them. It will give you good roleplay stuff. And what can happen to those pilots? Yeah, they need to go to briefings, but they can, for example, if they crash, they can be captured by Russians. they can be interrogated, they can be rescued by the SAS, and you will see real 3D cutscenes while this happens in real time. Yeah, you don't need to fly them, you can even watch them. This basically could also watch this as some sort of war simulation. And that was never be done. It is sometimes amazing. This game is so old. And like I said, it was a lot of other aspects are okay, we are in a game. Yeah, and I said this peacetime thing I think includes some sort of a short tutorial. You will also do some training flights, but you don't need to do, you don't need to do anything in this flight sim. You can also stay and watch. Yeah, that is, tutorial is integrated. And this, for example, the pilot mess, currently nothing is happening, everybody is happy, because there's currently is everything is fine. But of course, war is already brewing up, but nobody's expecting it. Yeah, and that's our pilots, everybody's sitting in the mess doing stuff. And but you can also, for example, go and press this button and see what is happening on Iceland currently. Yeah, there's some, yeah, the tutorial will, you can disable the tutorial in the options. And this is, for example, some bomber. I guess they fly also. There's no, it is displaying that a bombing is going on, but currently there's no war. I guess they fly some training missions. And that's our pilots. They're currently in this airfields, but you can also move them if you want. Yeah, options. There's not many settings. Yeah, difficulty levels. Yeah, now somebody's receiving a mission. Harmony, yeah, went to mission briefing. And everything is running in real time. It is like 24. 24 the flight sim. If you know the TV series 24. That is like 24. They should really post a timer in the mid. This, somebody should do a mod. And then you see if all pilots. There should be a button, 24 mode, and then you see the timer. And every pilot gets a box. What is happening to this guy? That would be best mod ever. Yeah, what is this button here? Yeah, interesting is also that it looks like they work together with the Eurofighter GmbH. So it looks like those guys really, I guess back in the days, Eurofighter was still very interested in selling their planes. I mean, a video game can also help to sell games, of course. Don't underestimate PR, no matter which PR. So, yeah, and you will receive over time news reports. We can look what. Yeah, okay, they are really in planning now. Harmony is in planning, but let's watch this news report. What happened here?
NATO says it's worried about the movement of tanks and artillery around the borders of Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania. American intelligence shows the Russians are gathering near the town of Riga. A White House spokesman has said that despite various attempts to organize talks, there have been no meetings between US President Helena Campbell and Russian leader Vladimir Chichikov.
Yeah, why is nobody able to do it like this? Why? I mean, we have games with super hardcore graphics, yeah? We have, I don't know, the detailed representation of Syria, of Caucasus or whatever. And then you need to, you have aircraft, beautiful models, every single button modeled, 100 weapon systems, helm-mounted cams. And then you go into a sortie or in a mission. Yeah, you need to fly a cap. Your planes, you have two planes, the enemy might have four planes. Have attack. Yeah, what is this? Like some 8-year-olds designed those missions. I don't know, is it... But I talk with many enthusiasts that also play Sims and War Games. They often respond the same, that those campaign presentations are so dry, so basic, while the other systems are over the top, which is fine. I mean, I also like great graphics. And like I said, I would like to play this with a proper modeled Eurofighter, yeah, something like Falcon. Falcon is of course really a great combi, but you know what I mean. Where you can start, boot up your Eurofighter. Here it is more action based, which might also be interesting for some. And yeah, you can also with Go, if you check out stuff here, you can also wait. Which button do I need to press? I don't see anything. Was it? Ah, see, it's the weather. So see the. Ah, I get it. Okay. Wait, I'm currently trying to handle my camera. Isn't there a button for the camera? Was it? Wait, I have the keys here open. Let me check out. Cameras are F buttons. And perhaps this only works for specific planes. Yeah. And but what we will do now is we will switch to the wartime version, because but I like I would play this campaign, but it takes some time until the war spools up. A lot of stuff will happen, and you will do training flights, or you simply watch what the heck is going on here. Are they doing some training here, or is it already Russian aircraft? Now they're doing training. Let's start in wartime. Yeah, I don't know. This time we will select. Ah, come on, same pilots. Come on, get that Duke here. Yeah, I think they are doing some training missions. Okay, now we are starting in wartime. You will still. It is not full war, but now Iceland is about to get getting attacked, and I think diplomatic is. The diplomatic means are already is clear that a war might come. And yeah, about the visual and the music of this game, I don't know, it gives me the Metal Gear Solid vibes. I mean, Metal Gear Solid was released a year ago or 2 years ago, I don't know, and or Metal Gear Solid 2, it has something to its visuals, it gives me the Metal Gear Solid. Also the music, if you hear the music, this it reminds me really. And also the UI style, I don't know, it gives me the Metal Gear Solid vibes. This modern, this military techno thriller visuals. Yeah. I would also say, you know, Metal Gear Solid is also some, of course, a bit science fiction and fantasy, but it is also a techno thriller, military techno thriller. What you might also call Clancy novels and whatever. And this has really, they managed this audio-visual representation. I mean, sure, it's old-school graphics, but it still has a good concept. And yeah, if you hear the music, I mean, we can go here. The music is now a bit low because I tuned the game down, but it has, it is shooting. It is tense. When the war is brewing up, it gets, the music really hits this, there's some threat. And the visuals as well. It looks like only Eurofighters have camera controls, okay. And that's perhaps one why one Eurofighter crashed, okay. Yeah, and similar to Falcon, you can take control of your aircraft, but you can also release it again. Watch out, don't release the controls while you're in a dive bomb or whatever. Because it's the aircraft might crash. But if you're in level flight, then for example, you don't want to do it, don't want to fly home, you can jump to other pilots. It is difficult to keep the pilots alive. You can roleplay one pilot, basically, and focus on one pilot. You could be Midnight. Or you could be Duke. And let the other pilots do their thing. But they might die. I mean, you can't, of course, fly every single mission. As you see, everything is running. You also don't need to micromanage them, but expect them to die. Because the AI is not that good in preserving itself. Okay, currently nothing is going on. Let's speed up the game. and simply watch what is happening currently. The camera will also jump if something happens. Sometimes you can manually switch. Like I said in the beginning, it is calm, but when it spools up, this will become really tense also to watch. Because missiles will fly around and the camera will switch to everywhere. This is a smart cam. I think you can set it also to manual. Wait, is there buttons? Let's see. Smart views, F9. What is a smart view? Smartphone. Choose best target, gear, blah, blah. Toggle moving map. Wild Weasel command menu. Yeah, and when Duke is in air, I will show you quickly the plane, so you have an idea. I mean, in the end, it is okay. He's taking off. Let's let him take off. When he's flying, we will take over the plane. Okay, the camera switched. Here is, I guess that's Duke and his wingman. Yeah. And here I can, yeah, let him stabilize, and I mean I can already take over. And then you simply click here and you're in the cockpit. So, yeah, as you see, yeah, the MFDs, the cockpit is basically, I mean, the cameras are, you have, yeah, cameras are somewhat like, I don't know, in Ace Combat or I guess Strike Fighter. The cockpit is simply here for, yeah, making it more beautiful, but you see nothing is modeled in this cockpit. It is really like an Ace Combat or Strike Fighter. That is fine, but could be of course better. It is, I mean, it is a matter of taste, right? It's not, it is not not about, but yeah, I prefer of course more fidelity sims, as most of you do as well. And yeah, currently looking in the menu, and exactly, this is the wingman menu, and it, yeah, you can give orders to them, but you won't hear a response. And I heard this is because something is on modern systems, but it's okay, it's not that of a big deal. Yeah, ATC, as you see, is also not heard. If somebody might manage to fix this, yeah, you have those two auto radio buttons there. They look like in some car, which gives you a throttle. Okay, cycle air to ground weapons, brimstone. Yeah, okay, and MFD 1 and 2. Yeah, here that's, oh man, it's always those special buttons. You can even trigger a third MFD. Yeah, and you have some stuff. For example, this here is quite interesting. We are currently targeting a spy, a trawler. I guess we are about to check out what is this trawler. And you can also play this game with keyboard. I played it back in the days with keyboard. You can play it with joystick. Of course, you can play it with your over-the-top, with your hotas, whatever. But it is, like I said, it is quite from flight mechanics, a simple game, but it is still difficult. I mean, if you're younger, challenges appear bigger because back in the days I didn't know that much about air-to-air combat or flight operations in general, aerial warfare. I simply was flying and was thinking, what the hell, from where are all those Russians coming? you can't compare. I mean, just because as a kid you think something challenging doesn't mean it is really challenging. But I remember as a kid, as perceived it as a challenging, even on the easier difficulties, but perhaps it's completely fine. We will face an invasion, and I guess you need to do something in order to prevent it. Also, as a player, you need to have an impact with your Eurofighter pilots and need to keep them alive. Yeah, and so the campaign starts. I mean, we can, and if you jump out now again, I mean, is there something to showcase from the plane? Yeah, I mean, those special buttons, yeah, you can switch those MFDs as you like. Think Strike Fighter did something similar. Declutter HUD, Yeah, cycle weapons, that is, I think that is a game, if you have at least some experience with flight sims, you might play it get into it in 5 minutes. And like I said, you can play it basically with all controls, whatever you desire. I don't see a problem here. Yeah, I mean the views, yeah sure, the views, I didn't finish it. Yeah, that's a wingman padlock. You have an external view if you prefer to play an external. Not sure if you can play external plus hood. I never play like this. Hey, currently I heard something. Did you hear it? Strange. Yeah, that is the action camera. You can activate it as well. And you will now check out this suspicious ship. And you can imagine what will happen with it. What is it? Brimstone. Yeah, but we will play it authentic. We will make a pass. On the other hand, we already ordered commencing attack. Nah, first check it out. We are not here to wage a war. Let's check out those guys. Stay with me. Maintain level flagged. Let's see what those guys are up to. Put me on your frequency. Trawler, November, Whiskey, 221, identify yourself. This is you, fighter. NITO aircraft. It's a bit, the controls are quite, but it's okay. Jimmy, can you see something down there? I don't know. What are they, wait, is it, are they already, oh, they're firing. Evade. But it is really a well-made campaign, I don't know. As I said, those campaigns, really, the how the war starts and everything, you check out those things, they fire on you and you know, okay, something serious is going on. Then you have, are they already landing? There's some red stuff on the map. Is it the Spetsnaz already here? Because I think first you will face some special force actions. And this live camera, this action camera, will also show you those enemy units. It is really great to watch them. And yeah, for me it is simply... Campaigns like Falcon... Like I said, I'm not a big fan of dynamic campaigns, because most dynamic campaigns in modern simulation and war games are so brutal boring, so brutal generic. And then, but then you have those things that already gave us good ideas. Nobody is trying to build on it. You know, with a Falcon I can understand it, because some might be afraid to be judged with the Falcon campaign. But UFO Factor Typhoon, nobody's talking nowadays anymore about UFO Factor Typhoon. This game is absolutely forgotten. And okay, Brimstone, how do I lock on? Choose target T. Let's hope this works. Yeah, what is fire space? Is it locked? Whatever, fire. But I can switch targets. Right, can I pause? Ah, you need to watch out. Yeah, P was paused, right? Yeah, this is this game. If you press... normally, in modern gaming, escape is basically standard button for pausing or going into the menu. Back in the days, it was not so. Old school flagged sims, escape was often the ejection seat. Here as well, if you press escape, nothing happens, and you then you press again escape, you might eject, because I think you need to press escape twice and you will eject. For the menu, you need to go simply here. This is, you always have access to this menu here, or and you can also play it with a mouse by right switching. Yeah, I don't think it's that useful. I don't know if somebody is mouse flying. I just want to see how can I switch targets. Right here. Can you do it while paused? Oh, that is great, for especially for people that that need the time. This would be great, perhaps, I don't know, perhaps it is possible in Falcon. This would be great for complex flight sims to work out stuff, you know, if you're on a bombing run and need to do 10 things. And but perhaps it works in DCS. I never did it. Not sure if MFD displays work in DCS while paused. Could be that they are working. Okay, so we are fired. I think he's already tracking. I'm not sure. I think the Brimstone doesn't need to be tracked. See, yeah. I think they are staying on the targets. Is the missile failing? It looks like. Let's fire another one. Yeah, some of those missiles fail. I remember this. Okay. Oh. Is he still alive? Shit. But I think now he's... Okay, now he's gone. Okay. And let's say you, for some reason, want to go what Red Hat is doing. I would, you can, for example, go in stable flight and switch a pilot. Let's see. I mean, the action camera, I guess, will be tuned to this guy. Perhaps activate autopilot beforehand with A. So can we switch to this other aircraft? I don't know if there's a button for switching to. If you press, would be great if there would be an observe function without jumping into the cockpit. Okay, whatever. But let's speed up. Not sure if you need to activate autopilot beforehand. But I think the game will activate the autopilot after 20-30 seconds if they notice that no pilot or no player is sitting in. But better activate autopilot before you leave there. Okay, Midnight is also now in the air. The rest is still enjoying. You know, some trawler blew up in front of Iceland, and everybody's chilling with a absolutely fine. Yeah, we see Duke is doing now something. Yeah, some aircraft. That's, I think that's Duke. No, that's Midnight on a wild weasel roll. Yeah, we will speed up and you will see stuff will happening. There's even some report. You see, the war in Europe is already going on, and that's basically wartime. But I like it that they put in a peacetime mission, because I think this period between peacetime and war is, especially in Cold War scenarios, one of the most important. And the developers realized that this is simply a tense phase, and you can use it for flying around. Sure, if you play 10 times the campaign, you might jump into the wartime. That's also what they realized. Okay, let's speed up the game to show you how the hell will become loose. Currently not much is happening. Let's see if Duke is really... Nah, he's doing something. He's now returning. Yeah, something appeared here. A Typhoon sub was located by ASW assets, and Harmony is being briefed on it. Yeah, Duke, you really know what you're doing? I mean, yeah, sure, otherwise. Let's check out Duke. See if I put him on autopilot. Because you need to put those guys on autopilot. I don't know, but I remember last time. Yeah, but be safe and put him on autopilot, so that they don't fly into the ground. But I think he was already on autopilot.
Montgomery, BBC News.
That's how you do a campaign. That's how you create immersion and atmosphere. You don't need to go for some professional news news reels. I know this stuff costs money, it's hard to achieve. And if money is limited, put it into... But you can also create this with a newspaper article. Yeah, this doesn't require that much time. Simply some writing, perhaps a picture or whatever. And and that's also fine. You don't need to go this full super professional... What is this? Ah, that's a mission router. Okay. And this transfer currently not working. Oh, wait. Yeah, you can transfer pilots for some reasons if you want to have them closer for combat air patrol or whatever. The missions might also become different, what the engine is generating. Yeah, that we already saw. Yeah, currently it's only, you see, this brewing up, but soon it will start. We need to, it takes some time, so let's accelerate forward and simply watch what is going on. And yeah, enjoy the show. But you can always jump in and fly yourself. And imagine you would play something. I mean, I have, to be honest, I spent some money on DCS modules. I have great aircraft lying in my DCS account, but I don't spend time with them. Why is that? I mean, there are some great campaigns made. Sure, they are linear, but I think a good linear campaign is 10 times better than a crap dynamic campaign. For the A10, there are some good campaigns, but the engine is quite limited. At least you have some voice, some radio voices and proper briefings. I think there's a training campaign which is quite authentic. Three staged, of basically three campaigns that train you really quite authentic, not fully authentic, but quite authentic on an A10. That's on my list. And I think it was done by a true pilot, at least somebody who has knowledge. It's even, you know, just because somebody had a job doesn't mean he has a clue. And in certain things, so it's also, yeah. I know many soldiers who have absolutely no clue about what they're talking, no matter how many years they served. And yeah, but it's also fine, you know, if you simply know your stuff, you don't need to be a pilot. What I wanted to say was that, but it's of course a good predictor that you might know what you're doing. Very good predictor. Yeah, let's speed forward. Let's take a look at the map. Currently only one contact, the sub. Can I, if there would be, I think there was a button where you could select the camera, what the camera is looking at. I remember, that was really interesting. I mean, you can press on this button. Yeah, okay, that's possible, but sometimes it is done stacking to one aircraft. Was there not something this previous next waypoint? Perhaps the smart views. No, F10, F11, F12. Okay, now I can use, for some reason I can use this. Yeah, you can use F5 for looking around, but sometimes the smart view takes over then again. Like I said, I think there is an option that you can control it completely manually. Switch all units that are currently active. And now not much is going on, but later it will become quite busy on Iceland, and then it really is fun to watch it. But it is, yeah, I can't remember fully. Okay, Duke is, can I see it? Is it Duke on attack run? What is going on? Interdiction mission, strike roll, heading to target. I think that's our man here, man. That is Duke. I think he's checking out a Typhoon sub. Yeah, I see something on the horizon. Was it? Nah, Harmony is checking out the sub. Oh, no. Oh, what is going on here? Yeah, oh, shit, wait. Activate autopilot. Yeah, missile attack. Now it's starting, but I want to watch it, but I mean, but it looks like the Typhoon launched a cruise missile attack. She's trying to gain altitude. Oh yeah, she's attacked. Oh oh. Phew, that was close. And you can even see the single shells coming to her. Okay, now she has enough altitude in order to stay away from man pets. Let's see what is else happening. I think now. Oh! Duke? Duke is shot down? Oh no! What happened to Duke? Are there already aircraft on the map? Oh, something is going on here. That is not only is it the Typhoon launched some Spetsnaz fighters? Yeah, Duke needs to be rescued. But they can also die if nobody comes around. Or they can capture by the enemy. We will see what happens. It's really a great drama simulator. But yeah, the AI has hard time to stay alive. Not sure what happened to Duke, if he went for this Typhoon on its own, because I think Duke was the guy who we played first, right? Not sure what the problem was. But like I said, I'm not playing seriously here. If you play seriously, you have different results. Soviet cruise missile incoming. Check it out. Yeah, here it is. Yeah, I need to wait. Is it in the settings or was it in the ini in the config file? Yeah, somewhere I think you can. Whatever, it's fine. Yeah, cruise missile inbound. Gets launched from those subs. Other cruise missiles. Quite far away, but I mean Iceland is also big. Okay, Red Hat is getting ready, getting the aircraft ready. Oh, Duke died. Ay ay ay. Came too late to help. Duke is gone, and it is permadeath. If those guys are gone, I don't know if they are replaced. I don't think so. The worst that can happen to you is that you're down to one pilot, and then you need to control one pilot, basically, as it would be you. You hear the sound ring in the background. That's, I don't know, it's this Metal Gear Solid style. Yeah, this espionage, modern techno, modern military techno thriller. Really good style, I like it. Yeah, I just want to get further into the invasion, that you see how everything becomes then loose. The war is not even started. We already lost one pilot, but they are not even coming yet. Okay, something appeared here. If I could switch the camera, I don't know how this worked out. Should I want also to prevent that you cheat around with your event camera? It's completely fine. gear up is G is free, didn't used. Man, why didn't you use G? Normal button, international button for gear is G, not U. Gear up, down, U. Yeah, there could be, sometimes I have the feeling there could be issues if you jump into a cockpit, that it might sometimes, why do I see this autopilot engage thing? It's sometimes confuse the AI, I have the feeling. Best is to try not to get into aircraft if you want to watch something or if you want the AI to completely handle it. Okay, so we exploded there. Avoiding missile. Cruise missiles avoiding a missile, and those are some advanced missiles. Oh, what is this? Somebody's intercepting. And he got the cruise missile. Scramble mission, yeah, I guess against those cruise missiles. Yeah, I mean those faces are pretty likely. I guess the first one that you might first face a submarine and bomber attack. What's this? Neutral territory, Harrier. Okay. The game is far from perfect, yeah. Like I said, it is far from perfect, but the idea of the campaign and how it works and those pilots, that nobody worked this idea out is really, it's a shame, absolute shame. In general, there were this squadron management, I know there was also this B-17 Flying Fortress, where you also basically manage pilots and there were so good ideas in the 90s and early 2000s, yeah, in war games or in simulations where you had to manage pilots, to manage tank crews and whatever. And most of the stuff got dropped and everybody just did games like Mission 1, attack enemy frontline. Mission 2, attack inbound mix. Yeah, no presentation, you simply start on the runway. And nothing. Sure, this takes resources, but I think this is absolutely well spent resources and 10 times better spent than, I don't know what, getting the newest, I don't know, graphics or getting 20 different islands nobody is almost using. Or islands or terrain. Or getting a ton of dynamic campaigns of all front lines, but every campaign plays the same with random missions. Perhaps do it. Do one good thing, focus on quality, not on quantity. Okay, now something new is incoming. Could be bombers or whatever. But I want you to show you the land attack, and the, when the Russians are coming in those amphibious ships, then it becomes really... What is this? There's already Russians now. These are Eurofighters. Yeah, and I advise you save often and use all slots. This game might have the complex dynamic engines like this, of course, have the risk, especially as I told you, I'm not sure, but I think it was. I can't tell about the stability or whatever of it. I remember something was back in the days that there was bugs and whatever, but not sure how much of this was fixed. So always maintain good amount of saves. Okay, they're all intercepting. A villain is going in. Why is he red? Ah, because he said, okay, dogfighting. Okay. Yeah, looks like he got a cruise missile. Oh. Looks like he got attacked. Is there a sub? So. Something on the surface. Yeah, he is attacking a cruise missile. Sub launch cruise missile. And what I also heard is really, in order to succeed, the beginning is really important. In the beginning, the Russians will first, of course, try to destroy installations of you, and yeah, you are not the only one on the battlefield. The others are also important. There are also ground units, everything. And the beginning phase is the most important in order to make sure that you might win this campaign, as it would be in reality as well, because they will come with a big invasion force, amphibious force, and every of those amphibious ships, I don't know, is carrying a lot of vehicles and troops. And if you manage to destroy them on the sea, it makes this, of course, way more impactful than trying to get them destroyed when they are landed and deployed. With all whatever they have, their SAMs and man pads. So I remember back in the days there was a strategy guide that is even included in this package I showed you. It would be nice to see what is it mentioning. There's basically a strategy book for it. You know, back in the days they released for games. Nowadays I think it's almost non-existent because of the internet. But back in the days they always said there were some official cooperation partners which created guidebooks for roleplay games, for simulations. What is this? Redhead. What? What did the redhead here? He destroyed. Was he there? No. What did he do? Yeah. Let's play some. Read some newspapers. I want to continue my newspaper. I'm not interested in awards. Can I see what this guy got? Right, pilot rooster. Yeah, cruise missile intercepts currently, and sub attacks. Yeah, as you see, and oh. Typhoon adds.
the first time that Typhoon fighters have been involved in offensive action. The aircraft was said to have performed well. A group of Allied supply ships has been attacked in the North Sea, 400 miles from the coast.
But Typhoon fighters will...
There's little chance of crew surviving in the freezing cold waters. There's little doubt the Russian submarine Yeltsin, which was under surveillance by the Swedish Navy, was responsible. In Brussels today, there's outrage that unarmed ships are being attacked. Stay tuned to EBC for further updates.
I want to be rescued by SAS. I don't know if you will manage in this video. Like I said, it's not a mini campaign. Yeah, this, I mean, the main thing of the game. So it is great that it, of course, takes time. And you shouldn't play it like I showcase it you, but I have no other means to showcase you the big invasion. And yeah, do you to getting results in this invasion, but play it for fun, you know. I remember in my first campaign, I think the Russians were completely steamrolling us, and I really liked it, because it felt... Yeah, you felt like the underdog. And they bring more and more stuff onto the onto Iceland, and you will fight everything from masses of ground troops to aircraft. Iceland bombard... Yeah, we won't watch it. I don't want to spoiler you, play the game, and we will focus on... I think after cruise missile phase, it should soon start, that they will... Like in Red Alert, units will suddenly come... Red Alert, what was it, 1 or 2? Nah, 2 I think, best... Was it 1? Both have, I think, good, yeah, both have good intros. About those Russian invasions. Currently it's calm, but it's about to start. I think soon it's about to start. What is this guy upon? Russian bomber intercept. Okay, so the Russian bombers are now coming. Soviet MiG-27s inbound. Iceland threatened with invasion. Okay, soon I think it... Just some bombers. I guess they are diversion. Those MiG-27s are just subversion. Yeah, I forgot the Red Alert soundtrack. Normally, when they come, you need there's one soundtrack every game should be allowed to play when a Soviet invasion is upcoming. It is really the. If I would be Russian and I would go in, I would also listen to it. Yeah. Yeah, wait, I can't tap out of the game. We can manage it. Oh, okay, they're already fighting. Yeah, we'll play some custom music now also because the music plays on random, it seems, which is fine, so it doesn't get if you hear those same songs too often, especially in the flight sim, if you're flying, it is rather unusual to hear it. But it also works with those sometimes music, sometimes not, to give you diversity. You see the camera is now shifting more and more often, stuff is spooling up. Everything is launched because everybody knows what is coming. Yeah, he's in the... Yeah, assassinated those bombers. But yeah, this was quite cocky of them. You don't say. The Eurofactors of the Eurofactor GmbH needs to manage it, it seems. Wild Weasel roll? Wild Weasel against what? Simply checking it out. What are they briefed on? Briefing, top secret. Okay, this guy is still on a bomber intercept, he's on a combat air patrol. She's on a combat air patrol. Let's see, I guess he's also briefed on something like a cap. I'm not sure if the map really shows everything or everything that is detected. I guess stuff that was detected. Yeah, let's see, how is Duke? Man, come on, get this guy out of there. Or is he gone? Yeah, come on, get him out of there. I think they will get him out and then you get, I don't know, a different scene. Not sure if it is stuck to this shocking end. Denied. Perhaps you can replace, but I think not. Not sure if you can replace this time. Combat air patrol. Russian bomber intercept 2 getting into the plane. Looks like the new bombers incoming. I like that you have this information always what they are doing. Did I already kill those bombers? Military experts. Suggest to act quickly. Ah yeah, thanks military experts. Goddammit, Ice Exit hier. Okay, they're on the way. Oh, what is this? Are they already here? Can I play the Word Alert soundtrack already? Nah, but I think when they come there will be a lot more red dots, if I remember correctly, but I don't know anymore. We're running real time. Didn't notice. Taking bombers, it seems. Major Elliot shipping losses in the Atlantic. Where are you? Come! I want to see the invasion fleet. On the other hand, it is good. That's exactly how you need to do it. And I think the peacetime campaign is even more extensive, that they really prepare for this climax of the war, Icelandic war, battle of Iceland. Well, I should have got a save game somewhere in order to show it to you. I didn't have this in memory that it takes so long, which is completely perfect. It's good that it takes so long. I can't hide anymore. Nobody is relaxing in the mess. I think if you're in this vision, you also won't take control. CSM strike? What is a CSM again? Counter ship missile? No. I wonder if there's a dynamic campaign, if you blast all those submarines into pieces, if, I don't know, environmental disaster will be triggered. No! Okay, that I can do, of course, for you. Yeah, currently I have to talk on another line.
Russian resolve strengthens. Large air battles rage across Europe and new territories occupied by the Russians. Reports from inside Russia suggest there's a high level of public support for the recent actions, with television showing the results of successful military operations across Europe. In the meantime, large-scale battles are continuing in the air and on the ground, with untold casualties. Governments are advising civilians to stay undercover and stay put, hoping that millions will survive under occupation rather than perish trying to flee the fast-moving front line. In recent actions, Russian forces have driven a front across Poland, stretching along the River Vistula. NATO forces have fought a successful holding and rearguard actions, allowing significant numbers of units to regroup in preparation for counterattacks. Claire Montgomery, EBC News. Bulletin. Russian invasion force secures beachhead on Iceland. Russia has landed its first troops on Iceland. The attack, which has been anticipated for some time, was swift and violent. Assault forces were led by a group of fast hovercraft, punching a landing corridor for their main invasion force through Allied defences. Russian units ashore are from a crack frontline landing force tasked to secure the beachhead. Allied forces on the island are preparing for a major conflict. Here's Bob Harris.
This message is brief, as we're expected to get hit at any moment. The troops are as ready as they can be. The much-talked-about Typhoon fighters are already in the fray. There will be casualties, and there will be many. We will try to get reports out as and when we can. Bob Harris on Iceland.
NATO says the assault on Iceland will stretch Russian military forces, and if Icefall can put up a good fight, it'll buy much-needed time for Europe. In the meantime, the loss of Iceland will hamper US efforts to reinforce NATO efforts. Claire Montgomery, ABC News. Icefall loses key air base on Iceland. The Russian invasion of Iceland's continuing at an alarming pace. A few hours ago, enemy ground forces took control of a key Allied airbase on Iceland, giving them a secure foothold with which to continue their punishing assault against the Icefall. While it's unclear how the Allies will respond, it's certain that reinforcements won't be available for some time.
Yeah, sorry, I have an important call. Need to quit the video. But we will finish with a red alert tune of the incoming invasion. Yeah, play the game yourself, and this really, at least the campaign, needs to see something like this. And in simulations and war games. Yeah, ended up to be a quite good Finnish video, right? Yeah, I don't know. The difficulty, because it is already reporting here, Soviet strategy ground plan retreating, but. Could be that's because they not have everything on the map. Okay, see you.